Good morning. Today we are starting with the inverse circular function questions. Graph I told last time. What was the graph for this that I told? Graph initially I told then I told you what is the domain of this function, what is codomain of this function or the range of this, because this is a 1-1 on 2 function because inverse is possible here. Now what type of question they will ask? First they will ask what is principal value. So when you think about principal value, for example, if I say find out sine inverse root 3 by 2. This is the question we have. We are asking what is the principal value of this. Whenever they ask the principal value of this, this root 3 by 2 coming from here, it is between minus 1 and 1. That is no problem. Now we want what should be its value. Value means if I take this as theta, then we should say sine theta is coming root 3 by 2. And theta will actually come from this portion because this is coming from here. And this final result always come between minus pi by 2 and pi by 2. Sine theta is coming root 3 by 2 and the value which it will give in quadrant number first and the fourth. And one thing we have already done, that sine comes out to be positive here, minus come out to be in the quadrant number 4. So negative is here, but in this case it is only positive. So sine theta is coming root 3 by 2. So that means theta is simply come out to be pi by 3. So we should say the principal value of this function, inverse function, will be coming pi by 3. Another example, sine inverse minus half. When you think about minus half, we'll take this as theta. Then I should say sine theta comes out to be minus of half. And as it is coming minus here, that means it will be in the quadrant number 4. And in quadrant number 4, if it is half, half means here we have already done that either the value is minus theta or 2 pi minus theta. But this time 2 pi minus theta will not take because we are taking the angle from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So it is 0 and this will go to minus pi by 2. So that means only minus theta is to be taken. Sine theta is coming minus half. Half is at pi by 6. So with what you should say, theta is come out to be minus pi by 6. So the principal value in this case will be pi by 3 and here it will be minus pi by 6. So that you should keep in mind. So this is the first question we have done. One more question, if I say find out the principal value of sine inverse half. Again, we'll take this as theta. And then in this case, sine theta comes out to be half. And as it is in first quadrant, we should say the angle is between 0 and pi by 2. So theta is simply come out to be pi by 6. Same way when they say sine inverse minus 1 by root 2. Sine inverse minus 1 by root 2. When you take this, then I'll take theta. It come out to be sine theta is coming minus 1 by root 2. As it is minus, it will be going in quadrant number 4. And here the theta comes out to be minus of pi by 4. So these values are simply called as principal values of the function. One more question is noted here. Sine inverse 2x minus 3. Find the domain of this function. Now second type of question is find domain of the function. The question is sine inverse 2x minus 3 is your y, or we should say it is fx. There is no problem. Now they are asking what should be the domain of it. Domain means what the value of x we can place here. That is the domain. Here in this case, one thing is clear, that whenever sine inverse is there, this value always comes between minus 1 and 1. One thing we have already decided, that this value always come out to be between minus 1 and 1. So that means I should say in this case 2x minus 3 should always come between minus 1 and 1. And as it is coming between minus 1 and 1, now you can calculate what is x. So minus 1 plus 3, this will be 2x minus 3 plus 3, and this is 1 plus 3. Now when you solve it, it will be 2, this will be 2x, and this will be coming 4. And then clearly x is coming between 1 and 2. So what should be the domain in this case? Domain of this function will be between 1 and 2. So this way you can have the questions here. Next question is, find the domain of the function. Find the domain of the function sine inverse x square. Find the domain of the function sine inverse x square. When you think about x square, we should say x square is coming between minus 1 and 1. First, we'll write this. But here, minus 1 cannot be possible. So, we should say x square is coming between 0 and 1. And if x is coming between, x is between 0 and 1, automatically x is also coming between 0 and 1. Is it right or no? Or something wrong here? Just find out what should be the value here. Yes, please. It is coming 0 and 1. Is it valid? Or it is some other value? X square is coming between 0 and 1. X square is coming between 0 and 1. Or I should say x square is less than or equal to 1. We should check this. What we are doing is wrong. You can't take under root this way. So we should say x square minus 1 is coming less than or equal to 0. Or I should say x plus 1 into x minus 1 coming less than 0. Then we go on number line. This will be minus 1 and 1. When you take the value less than minus 1, it will be minus. It will be minus. So net is plus. Then we go from minus 1 to 1. 1 will be plus. Another will be minus. So it is minus and it is plus. What will be the value of x coming now? It will come between minus 1 and 1. When x is between minus 1 and 1, where x square will go? Between 0 and 1. So what will be the domain in this case? X will be coming between minus 1 and 1. Same way when you have the cos function, inverse of cos. The inverse when you have taken, this value has gone from 0 to pi. This was the function for cos inverse. Whenever we have cos inverse function, it goes from minus 1 to 1 to 0 to pi. Now how we'll do the So first question which we have on this cos. Now in this case, whenever you are thinking about cos, domain will be minus 1 to 1, but the range or the codomain is between 0 and pi. So 0, pi by 2, pi. Cos will be plus here, cos will be minus here. Here the value simply comes theta and here it comes pi minus theta. Now for example, if they ask you will find the value of cos inverse minus root 3 by 2. So when you just say cos inverse minus root 3 by 2, then I should say this is theta. Then what will be cos theta this time? It will come out to be root 3 by 2 minus is here. Minus means here the angle comes. First, don't think about minus. We'll decide that later. Root 3 by 2, it comes out to be pi by 6. But as it is negative, so it will be in the quadrant number 2. So here what theta should be coming as pi minus pi by 6. Or I should say theta is coming 5 pi by 6. So this is the value we have for cos inverse minus root 3 by 2. For example, if they say cos inverse minus 1 by root 2. When they say cos inverse minus 1 by root 2, again we will say this is theta. Then cos theta comes out to be what? Minus 1 by root 2. And 1 by root 2 at pi by 4, and it is in the second quadrant. So where theta should go? Pi minus pi by 4. So it will come out to be 3 pi by 4. So this way you can get the value. Same way if they say cos inverse sine 4 pi by 3. Cos inverse sine 4 pi by 3. The first thing we should find out what is the value of it, then we'll think about further. Cos inverse. this I'll write sine of pi plus pi by 3. Then this has come out to be clearly sine 90 into 2 plus of 60. It will be going in quadrant number third. Quadrant number third, so it will be minus. And it's an even multiple, so sine will remain as sine, so sine 60. So actually this question is cos inverse of minus root 3 by 2, which you have already done. What that value came? This is theta, then cos theta comes out to be minus root 3 by 2. And then theta comes out to be pi minus pi by 6, come out to be 5 pi by 6 is the answer. Same way, now if they ask the question, find the domain of cos inverse x plus cos x. Find the domain of cos inverse x plus cos x. Now when you think about it, this is the sum of two functions. And I told whenever we take the sum of two functions, their domain will be the intersection of the two. Whatever the domain of this, we'll find out. Its domain goes as minus 1 to 1. And this domain comes out to be all the real number. We have done that. And as I want the domain of this function, let this function is f. So domain of this function f will be the intersection of the two. So it will come out to be minus 1 to 1. This way you can have your question. Same way if they say find out the domain of 2 cos inverse 2x plus sine inverse x. 2 cos inverse 2x plus sine inverse x. Now if they are asking what is the domain of this function. When we think about the domain, first thing this. 2x should come between minus 1 and 1. Then automatically x comes out to be between minus half and half. This is the domain of first function. Here the domain of second function always comes between minus 1 and 1. And I want the intersection of the two. So when you think about the intersection, this is the smaller part. So this will be the common one. So domain of this function come out to be minus half to plus half. They can give this way, they can have the question. Same way when you think about 10 inverse. When you have 10 inverse function, the domain is here all the real number and its codomain or the range is between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, neither pi by 2 include nor minus pi by 2 include. So minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 open interval is the range we have. Now we are thinking about first question, find the value of 10 inverse minus root 3. Here we will have the quadrant which should be there is these two. This is pi by 2, this is minus pi by 2, here it is 0. So when you think about theta here, it will come out to be tan theta is minus of root 3. And when we have tan theta is minus root 3, it will be in quadrant number 4. And if it is in the quadrant number 4, what theta comes out to be minus of pi by 3. Because it's coming negative, so it will be minus pi by 3. Same way they say tan inverse 1 you find out. Let this be theta. Then clearly tan theta comes out to be 1. And if tan theta is 1 means it's a positive number. Positive is in the quadrant number 1. So theta is simply come out to be pi by 4. Now take next question please. Find the domain or find the principal value of tan inverse sine minus pi by 2. When you do this, what this value come out to be? Tan inverse sine of minus pi by 2 means minus sine pi by 2. then this come out to be tan inverse of minus 1. And if it is minus 1, that means this is theta now. So tan theta is coming minus 1. Minus 1 means it is quadrant number 4. So theta is coming minus 5 by 4. So this way you have the principal value you can calculate. One more question. Find the principal value of cot sine inverse cos tan inverse 1. Now when you think about it, what this come out to be? Cot sine inverse cos tan inverse 1 is what? Nothing but pi by 4. Then it come out to be cos sine inverse. What is the value here? 1 by root 2. Now when you think about sine inverse, 1 by root 2, that come out to be cot pi by 4. And cot pi by 4 is clearly 1. So this way you can have the question. Next time we'll continue with this.